unless you're holed up on Gobbler's Knob with Punxsutawney Phil, you know that a new law will limit to $10,000 the amount you can deduct on your federal return for state and local taxes. This is terrible for high-tax politicians in high-tax states. We're thinking of one place with a struggling, jobs-challenged economy where citizens pay some of the nation's most egregious property taxes, yet taxaholic lawmakers just raised the personal income tax rate by 32%. A place that's losing population at an accelerating rate. Clue, starts with I, rhymes with unemployed. In the past, politicians could increase these state and local taxes to high heaven, then tell angry taxpayers to stop squealing, hey, the IRS lets you deduct everything you give us. Those rubes in low-tax Idaho, South Dakota, and Maine will subsidize you. Sweet, now, though, the limit on this deduction makes citizens in high-tax states likelier to rebel over the amount of other people's money the Pauls collect. But never underestimate the yearning of the tax and spenders to defend their right to more revenue. Hence news stories about blue state officials grasping for ways to game the new law. On Wednesday, Gov. Andrew Cuomo got a standing ovation during his State of the State speech by promising to challenge the law in court. Fair enough, but Cuomo also is exploring replacing his state's income tax with a state payroll tax, evidently paid by employers, much as they now pay half of their workers' dues to Social Security. Similarly, exotic talk in several states would have citizens able to avoid paying state income taxes by instead making fully deductible charitable contributions to their state governments. Struggle as we may, though, we can't imagine Congress, the Internal Revenue Service and a nation of federal judges reacting to any such moves with a pliant, shucks, you state people really showed us who's boss. Just do whatever you want to flout federal tax law. Legal experts find these blue state notions for gaming the new limit dubious. What's more, Democratic officials got some free tactical advice from University of Chicago law prof Daniel Hemmel, who told the New York Times, the Democratic Party's long-term agenda requires the federal government being able to raise revenue. This would be short-termism at its worst, potentially setting back the progressive agenda for decades to come in response to a bad tax bill. Note what you're not reading here, quotations from state officials nationwide who understand that they have another option, lowering state and local taxes. That would make the new limit less burdensome for affluent citizens who'll still itemize deductions. A near doubling of the standard deduction and federal tax rate reductions will make the new limit irrelevant for many middle-income taxpayers who'll no longer itemize. We know, crazy talk, there are public employee unions to reward for the money and muscle they devote to re-electing friendly Pauls. There are interest groups that want higher taxes and more spending, not lower and less. There are governments that rely on rising revenue to employ precinct captains, nieces, brothers-in-law, and other connected payrollers.